Gonzalez. And of course, April was now last month. Happy May, everybody. And April was, of course, Autism Awareness Month, which means as we go right into May, it is Mental Health Month. And who better to talk to us about what that means for our island community and what is being done about it than the director of the Guam Behavioral Wellness and Therese Areola. I always get the name of your agency. What is it?
Guam Behavioral Health and Wellness Center.
What used to be Department of Mental Health.
Right.
Yeah.
Right, right,
but
right.
But it is the proper politically correct name now. And you were very happy with that.
I'm very happy because, of course, one of the things. Well, first of all, thank you, Jason, for KUAM for having us. I'm very happy to.
Our pleasure, as always.
To be here to share with the community what their Guam Behavioral Health and Wellness Center is here to serve them and all the events that we have planned for the month of May, because May is Mental Health Month, and our minds do matter, our emotions do matter, and the Guam Behavioral Health and Wellness Center is here to ensure that the people of Guam know that we're here to serve. We have a slew of wonderful professionals, psychiatrists, psychologists, counselors, therapists, here to help, because, you know, similar to how we go to the hospital when we break a bone. Well, there's absolutely nothing wrong when your mind is hurting or your emotion is hurting to seek a different type of assistance or a doctor.
I've said for years, everybody should go through therapy at some point in their life.
I'm with you.
It's fantastic.
I'm with you. I think everyone needs an objective third party to talk to, just to make sure that we're okay. I mean, we all go through in our lifespan ups and downs and crises, and it's always good to know that there's somebody you can talk to. And that's one of the things that we really want to emphasize in our administration, is that Guam Behavioral Health is your go-to place. We have a 24-hour crisis hotline, 647-8833, 647-8833. If you feel anxious or you feel depressed or you feel like you just need to talk to somebody, that's the number to know.
And thank you for bringing that point up, Therese, because you come into this agency now. Of course, you've been a leader in the community for many, many years, but under the Leon Guerrero administration, you're now leading this agency during pretty remarkable times, because I remember before when they used to say it was, you know, mental health affliction. People used to think it was a permanent disease, and it was things like schizophrenia or, you know, pretty substantial afflictions. But as you said, mental health now covers
it
mild depression, anxiety.
Depression, anxiety.
Which can also be temporal.
Yes, a trauma from something traumatic in your life. I mean, you know, like I said, we're all human beings. We all go through different stages in our lives. We go through ups and downs, depressions, anxieties. And, you know, we're here. Guam Behavioral Health is here to say, you know, we're here to help. We are your go-to agency. And I have a wonderful slew of professionals and employees who... We're a Health and Human Service Department. We are here to serve.
You've got a lot of social workers, I know.
We have social workers, therapists, counselors. So we are there, case managers.
Now, because your scope is so much more broad than it used to be, the sheer nature of what you do and the amount of work that you have, I can only imagine, is staggering.
It's quite a bit, but I'm sure it's not as large as some other people or some other departments. I mean, I average at least 400 emails a day, so that's pretty overwhelming. But, you know, I have a wonderful staff, and we're just so excited. I'm really excited. I'm very honored that Governor Liu and Lieutenant Governor Josh Tenora has tapped me to be the leader of this wonderful department. I think it's definitely a challenge at a time when resources are small, but you know what? We're doing a lot of things at the department that I think the community needs to know. For example, we are opening, after being closed for over two decades, the inpatient drug and alcohol detox unit.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yes, and we're really excited because, you know, Guam Behavioral Health had that. But then after Typhoon Pangsamwa, the third floor was damaged, but we are ready to open. We're just getting the air conditioning in, and we're going to be opening it, because drug and alcohol addiction is also a priority of ours. We want to make sure that our community who has those afflictions know that we have the programs, whether it's outpatient and now, whether, you know, if they need medically detox, services that we're here. Mm.
So what else have you got going on? Because May, again, we're in the first day of the month. This is one of the longer months. So
yes.
That means you have a lot
and
of time to work with the community.
We have a lot of things going on.
You have a lot of time to evangelize.
Yes. And so, you know, this past Monday, Governor Liu had proclaimed May as Mental Health Month, and it was wonderful. We had all our stakeholders and our partners in the community join us down at Attaloop. This Friday, we invite the community to join us at 3 o'clock, where Senator Therese Terlahi, who's our oversight chair on health, will be presenting a proclamation, again, recognizing Mental Health Month. And then right after that, our entire Guam Behavioral Health family will be out at ITC waving, making sure that everyone knows that our minds matter, our emotions matter, and just support dropping the stigma that, you know, there's nothing wrong with that, with reaching out and getting help when you're going through some difficult times in your life. Mm-hmm. And so we'll be out there waving Friday, so we encourage everyone to honk your horn. I would like to challenge the community to either wear green or wear a green ribbon.
Any shade of green.
Any shade of green.
Right. That looks lovely on you, by the way.
Yeah, okay, thank you. And for the